Hello, I'm Dr. John Hancock, Executive Dean of McGovern Medical School. The use of cadavers in medical education, would you believe, dates back to 1231, when the Holy Roman Emperor, Frederick II, required the dissection of cadavers to be a key component of physician education. Since McGovern Medical School was founded in 1970, the anatomy course, including cadaver dissection, has also been a cornerstone of our medical training curriculum. Today's medical school students are able to supplement this traditional learning method with new technologies. Let's hear more from the faculty and students bringing the anatomy program into a new era.
It is extremely important that our medical students use human bodies as their first patient to learn the anatomy. It turns out that anatomy is one of the most critical courses for the students. The people that prepare the bodies are highly trained personnel. The people that actually teach in the laboratory have anywhere from 20 to 50 years of experience teaching in anatomy. And in addition, we have many practicing physicians that come and visit the lab. The virtual reality programs help the students to see the continuity of the systems. In the lab, we only do a particular region at the time. So the virtual reality is very valuable in putting together a whole system.
So what happened was that I was in my cardiology module and I was thinking, okay, how do I kind of visualize all of the heart structures in terms of pathology? And then I realized, well, I could do that if I go to the anatomy room. But at that point, we'd already finished anatomy, all the bodies had been cremated, so that wasn't really an option. So I was thinking, well, what's the solution for that? And so that kind of led me down to VR. And from there, it kind of spiraled into like, okay, well, that's only one half of the semester and possibly only one module. So instead, I was thinking, okay, what about the other half of the year? The foundational part where we do anatomy. That's probably where it have more benefit for it. And that's kind of how the idea of doing VR in anatomy kind of sprung in at least my mind.
When Jonathan approached me about this potential VR project, I was like, that's really amazing. I got to see the whole body in a 3D structure and I got to click on a muscle and then it would tell me everything about that muscle. What does it do? And it'll show me what it does. So it was really helpful resource to be able to, you know, synthesize all of the information that we need to know for anatomy, the action, innervation, the muscle, the artery, all of that stuff.
One big advantage of it is that you don't have to move the body. Some of the cadavers can be very heavy, very large, and it's not easy to find the small little nerves, the small little muscles. But in the software, you can always find it. There is a search bar, you can go find it yourself. It'll draw the pathways for you if you need. So that's kind of some advantages for it in terms of student feedback that we've gotten already.
We here at McGovern are trained to produce the best physicians we can. And combining the human cadaver experience with the virtual reality experience, I think, will be extremely beneficial for the students.
It's comforting to know that the medical school has and hasn't changed since I was a student. However, we can count on our educators to ensure that our students are well prepared for their medical careers, starting with a foundation course in anatomy. Thank you for joining me for this episode of Hancock's Headlines.